स्टूडेंट्स वेलकम टू द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ स्नैपशॉट लेसन सेकेंड द एड्रेस बाय मार्गा मिंको लेट्स हैव स्टूडेंट्स लेट्स प्रोसीड ऑन द नेक्स्ट पैराग्राफ ऑफ लेसन द एड्रेस Listen, the address of snapshot. Paragraph 3. Let's see its reading. Every time she leaves here, she takes something home with her, said my mother. She took all the table silver in one go, and then the antique plates that hung there. She had trouble lugging those large vases, and I am worried she got a crick in her back from the crockery. My mother shook her head pityingly. I would never have dared ask her. She suggested it to me herself. She even insisted. She wanted to save all my nice things. If we have to leave here, we shall lose everything, she says. Have you agreed with her that she should keep everything? I asked. As if that's necessary, my mother cried. It would simply be an insult to talk like that and think about the risk she is running each time she goes out of our door with a full suitcase or bag. My mother seemed to notice that I was not entirely convinced. She looked at me reprovingly, and after that we spoke no more about it. Students, see some words related to this paragraph as antique, that is related to olden days. Students, see words as antique, related to olden days or ancient day. Lugging means pulling forcibly. Lugging means when there are articles you might have seen on the station, etc. If our luggage are very big and some person pull it, carry it forcibly, that is called lugging. Other words, dragging. For this word, lugging can be used. Vases means safe and trunks in which we put our things. Sometimes vases are used as flower pots also, but here the meaning of vases, that is safe and trunks. Okay, crockery means things related to kitchen and dining, etc. Entirely, completely, or thoroughly. Convinced, agreed with. Reprovingly, that is frightening, okay, or in threatening way. Now, see the explanation of this paragraph. The girl now recalls the days when the woman visited her home, and at every return she took something her home in the name of safety. Okay, the woman took everything, some valuable or nice thing of the mother, narrator's mother, in the name of safety. Her mother told her daughter that she had taken all the silver table in one go. Then the old royal plates of ancient days that hung there in the dining. She had to take enough trouble in carrying those large vases and trunks in her journey, and also told her that while carrying bags filled with things, she got some cracks in her back. The daughter asked her mother, why did the woman take so pain? the mother shook her head sorrowfully and said that she would never have dared to ask her. See, the woman had suggested herself the things should be removed from the place for the sake of safety. Because during the war, she thought and convinced the mother that those valuable things cannot be safe here. And so, for the sake of safety of those nice things, she carried them. She even insisted on doing so. The greedy woman wanted to save her all nice things. She told her mother that if they leave the things there, they will lose everything. At this, the girl asked her mother if she had agreed with her that she would keep everything. At this, the mother got irritated and said that if that was necessary, she could. She further said that it would be simply an insult to talk like that. Mother also added in her praise to think about the risk she was taking each time when she went out of their door with suitcase or bags filled with things. It seemed that mother had noticed that her daughter was not completely agreed with her opinion. She looked towards her daughter angrily for the difference in her opinion. After that time, they didn't talk anything about it. Students, let's proceed on the next paragraph of this lesson. The address. Let's have reading. Meanwhile, I had arrived at the station without having paid much attention to things on the way. I was walking in familiar places again for the first time since the war, but I did not want to go further than was necessary. I didn't want to upset myself with the sight of streets and houses full of memories from a precious time. In the train back, I saw Mrs. Darling in front of me again, as I had the first time I met her. It was the morning after the day my mother had told me about her. I had got up late and coming downstairs, I saw my mother about to see someone out, a woman with a broad back. "There is my daughter," said my mother. "She beckoned to me." The woman nodded and picked up the suitcase under the coat rack. She wore a brown coat and a shapeless hat. "Does she live far away?" I asked, seeing the difficulty she had going out of the house with a heavy case. "In Marconi Street," said my mother, "number 46, remember that." Now, see the words related to paragraph 4. Upset means disturbed. Upset means got disturbed. Got up means woke up. Beckoned. Beckoned means indicated towards. Shapeless, unfit or unfitted to or not fit for a person, that is shapeless. Explanation of this paragraph. See, the girl, the protagonist of the story, chief character of the story, started to go back slowly towards the station, thinking about the events that took place during and after the war. As these things are chiefly related to during the war, and what the things took place, those were after the war. She was thinking about the differences as well as the chief event, the acquaintance with the lady. All these things were now coming into the mind of the protagonist. Thus, the girl had arrived at the station without having paid much attention to things on the way. She was doing so as those things were thought-provoking. Those things were related to her past, and from the time when the war was started, and now after the war was over and the peace was restored in the country, and now the country was free, between these two times there was much difference, and there were many things which were related to those people who were in existence few days ago. Now they were not in the world. Such things were very thought-provoking for the girl. Therefore, she did not like to mind everything on the way going the station. She did not pay much attention to those things. She was doing so as those things were thought arising. Okay, as I have told you, she was walking in familiar places again for the first time since the war. But she did not want to go further than necessary. She did not want to disturb herself with the sight of streets and houses full of memories from a precious time. After coming back in the train, the girl had again the glimpse of the lady, Mrs. Darling, in her mind. When she had occupied her seat, the face and figure of Mrs. Darling were now in her mind. She was thinking about those events which took place at the time of introduction, and on those days when her mother had made introduction with Mrs. Darling. Now her face was in her mind in the train. The things as well as the events of the past were in front of her eyes. The incidents of first meeting was clear to her now. It was morning. She could recall it clearly. That what was the time? It was the morning after the day her mother had told her about her. She had got up late on that day, and at that morning, coming down from the stair, she found that her mother was about to see off someone to the gate. The person was Mrs. Darling, the lady with broad back. Her mother had introduced her that she was her daughter. Mother of the girl had indicated towards her. The woman, Mrs. Darling, shook her head, and she picked up the suitcase under the coat rack. She took up the suitcase under the coat rack. She, that is the woman, had put on a brown coat and a shapeless hat. Seeing the difficulty she was facing while going along the luggage with a heavy case, the girl, the daughter of Mrs. S, had asked her mother where she lived, or she asked her mother where the lady lived. Did she live far away? Mother of the girl replied her that she lived in Marconi Street number 46, and also advised the daughter to remember that address. Students, let's proceed on the next paragraph of the lesson, the address of snapshot. Paragraph 5, its reading. I had remembered it, but I had waited a long time to go there. Initially, after the liberation, I was absolutely not interested in all that stored stuff, and naturally, I was also rather afraid of it. Afraid of being confronted with things that had belonged to a connection that no longer existed, which were hidden away in cupboards and boxes and waiting in vain until they were put back in their place again, which had endured all those years because they were things. But gradually everything became more normal again. Bread was getting to be a lighter color. There was a bed you could sleep in unthreatened, a room with a view you were more used to glancing at each day. And one day I noticed I was curious about all the possessions that must still be at that address. I wanted to see them, touch and remember them. After my first visit in vain to Mrs. Darling's house, I decided to try a second time. Now a girl of about 15 opened the door to me. I asked her if her mother was at home. No, she said, my mother's doing an errand. No matter, I said, I will wait for her. Students, see the words, as I think you might know it, I think I should make them clear again for you. As initially means in the beginning of, stored stuff means material that were kept safe, that is stuffed. Confronted, that is faced with. To face something is called confront, or in other words, encountered, right? So here meaning of confront means to face something. No longer existed means no longer alive. No longer existed or no longer in exist, then those persons are not alive. They are dead. Endured means had suffered. Unthreatened, that is fearlessly, undisturbed in sleep. Possessions, that is belongings. Material that belongs to someone, and collectively they are called wealth of a person, that is belongings. For a rich person, money and other gold materials are the possessions of that rich person. But for students, what are the possessions for a student? The student's possessions are the books, copies and bags and other instruments which help them in their studies. Here the wealth of the student is her or his studies, his books. They are their possessions. So here possessions means materials that belongs to someone and collectively create wealth. Glancing means looking something furtively or have a look on something, that is called glancing. So here the meaning of glancing according to the context of the lesson is facing, okay? And literal meaning of glance is to have a look over something is called glance. Now see the explanation of this paragraph. The girl, the protagonist of the lesson, kept that address in her mind, stored. The girl, the protagonist of the lesson, our daughter of Mrs. Yes, kept that address in her mind, stored. She had remembered that address, yet she had waited for a long time to go there. In the beginning, after the war was over, and the liberation of the country was restored, she was absolutely not interested in all those stored material, and it was natural that she was also rather afraid of those things which made the mind often haunt about. She was afraid of being faced with things that may related to those near and dear ones who were not alive now. Those things were hidden away from the common sight, hidden away in cupboards and boxes, and waiting in vain until they were put back in their proper places again. Those things had also suffered all those years of war and struggles in containment of cupboards and boxes, because they were things, not human beings. But as the time passed, the things began normal. As you know, the time is the best remedy for every kind of injury and wounds given by the people and given by the time. As I am deviating from a point, as the time of this corona period has given many wounds to the humanity, but its positive and negative impact will remain on our minds for a long time. And whatever wounds we have received, they are not going to remain forever. The time will come when those things will go off from our mind and we will start to become normal again and start to run on our daily routine without any hurdles, forgetting the pain of past and starting living in the present. The same thing the girl here discussed: as the time passed, the things begin to become normal. Bit by bit, everything began to occupy their common momentum as usual again. Bread that was kept, not had started to become, that had kept, I am sorry, bread that was kept for eating, now had started to become light in color. There was a bed which could provide comfort enough to enjoy sound sleep without having any mental disturbance caused by the fear of insecurity. It had a room with a look you were more habitual to look at every day. And one day, the daughter noticed that she was curious about all those things that must still should be at that address mentioned by her mother. With this thought, the daughter, the protagonist of the lesson, became restless to see all them, to touch them, to see all them, to see all those things, to touch those things, to remember those things. After the first visit of Hopeless to Mrs. Darling's house, the girl decided to try a second time. Now, a girl of about 15 years old opened the door to receive her call. The daughter asked from that 15 years old girl whether her mother was at home. The girl of 15 years replied her that no. She further told her that her mother does work of errands, that is, the work of carrying messages for the sake of having some money or some valuable things as a gift from those persons whom the work was being carried. These errand carriers are not regarded as very valuable portion of the society. Those people who are poor, those people who have not enough to eat and drink, such type of people are often engaged in such works. The girl of 15 informed the daughter of Mrs. Yes, the protagonist, that her mother does the work of errand for the rich persons. The protagonist responded that she would wait for her mother.